Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's jump straight into a new reaction, the dihalogenation. The full reaction is already shown, but we will need to provide the mechanism. Halogenations start with an alkene. Our reagent is Br2. Halogenations can involve I2, Br2, or Cl2. For the first step of this reaction, we will have three mechanism arrows. I'll mention each arrow separately, but keep in mind that all these electrons move at the same time. They don't move sequentially. First, we'll show the carbon-carbon pi bond attacking one of the bromines. Second, the bromine-bromine bond breaks with electrons going to the other bromine. Third, a lone pair on the first bromine will attack one of the alkene carbons. The result of this single step is the reaction intermediate. This strange structure is called a bromonium ion. Chloronium ion for Cl2, iodonium ion for I2. In general, a halonium ion. Three-membered rings are very unstable, so this intermediate will not stick around long. The bromide counterion, which is a nucleophile, will attack. Where will it attack? Let's think about our goals for this step. We need to break open this strained ring, and we need to give some electrons to this Br+. The positive tells us where the electrons need to go. To accomplish these goals, we will attack one of the ring carbons. This particular one, break the carbon-bromine bond and push the electrons onto the Br. That gets us to our final addition product, a dibromide. Let's talk about regiochemistry. You might say that because we're adding Br to both sides of the alkene, that there is no regiochemistry. You're right, but there is something to think about. When bromide, Br- attacks the bromonium ion, it attacks the more highly substituted carbon of the ring. Why? These carbon-bromine bonds are polarized with a partial plus on each carbon. Kind of running out of space, but both those carbons have a partial plus. That makes these carbons partial carbocations. Because the carbon on the left is more substituted, it is more willing to bear a larger partial positive charge. So it becomes more electrophilic and attracts the nucleophile. How about stereochemistry? Dihalogenation is an anti-addition. Let's see why with a cyclic alkene, cyclohexene. Here is the iodonium ion that forms from cyclohexene, and I've redrawn it toward the bottom with some perspective that hopefully makes it clearer. The incoming nucleophile, iodide, attacks from the opposite face, the bottom face, to open the ring. This step resembles an SN2, so you get inversion. The end result gives one halogen up and one halogen down, trans. That gives us the anti-product. Oxidation reduction, since we're adding electronegative halogens, dihalogenation is an oxidation. That is the dihalogenation. It's an addition with Cl2, Br2, or I2 onto an alkene. It's characterized by a strained halonium ion intermediate, which is opened at the more substituted carbon. The addition is anti and an oxidation.